So, and I'd like to say something now. You seem like a nice guy, so...
Thank you.
And I love your former president, not yours, but I thought he was a great man, because the gringos were sticking it to him, and they still are. So, I understand you were promoting that. Because it's all true. And so...
Well, can you move the microphone?
And repeat all of that.
Sorry, so
that's okay.
Okay, now it's even worse because it's louder. So let's be fair about this. I'm also part of this. I was born and raised in Wilmington. Most of my cousins are named Castro. And so the point is, let's just, you're a grown man and I am too. If you go to get a job somewhere and they look at it and they go, wow, so you've already called their district manager and said that we're bad guys. Now you're going to ask us, hey, I'd like to work here. Okay, that's just not going to work. So why don't we just settle this? Because I'm implicated in this. If you were to just, write another letter to City Hall and say, we talked it out, everything is fine. If you're willing to do that and just tell me that you'll bury this thing, at that point I won't have any problem against voting to have you as
mayor.
All right,
Paul, I'm
gonna... Can you hand me
the...
I'll let you hold
this.
I'll let you hold this.
I hear where you're coming from, but we have to follow procedure.
But no board should ever come to a point when there's a compromise. You take back your complaint and voila, we put you on the board.
Yeah.
If you keep the complaint going, I'm gonna be against you. That is exactly what he was pointing out in his letter. That is exactly what he felt that happened at that meeting, that he felt discriminated against. Now, he is asking you, and you guys are talking about a letter, and he was mentioning a letter about an apology. It's not even on your agenda. You only have him on the agenda, and I agree with Jay on this one. Focus, but it doesn't show that to the public. I didn't know you guys are gonna come. I did not see that on the agenda. When I saw the agenda, it only talks about his appointment. The first I heard about the letter was when I came to this meeting. I didn't see anything on the agenda that otherwise implicates or says anything about a letter. Set that with us aside, you can do whatever you want to do. But having an applicant come in or being asked, withdraw your threat or your letter or else. But if you do, we will put you on the board. This has nothing to do with being an employer. This has nothing to do with going to the management. From what regular people saw, reasonable people saw, was that he felt discriminated against. Ergo, if you guys have an issue with something, you probably pick up a pen, or you go to your computer, you write a letter. We all have done it. Okay? You're on the phone, you're with the company is being disrespectful, you speak your words. But for somebody to say, I'm sorry, I like you all, but this is showing not just a little bit of disrespect, definitely, but anybody who's ever felt a grievance. It wasn't even a grievance, you're treating it as a grievance, and like Jay said, you should have folded that grievance once you had that letter 2 months ago, and it didn't happen. There's one excuse I've done, I will not address this issue. Whatever you guys decide, he is qualified to be on the board. He has offered. Actually, I saw the YouTube video and he had you guys live on YouTube. This is something you can use. But to say in order to get on the board, take that letter back, that just doesn't sit right.
We'll get that again. Yeah. Real simple. Okay, the state of the poll was completely unanimous.
I agree with that.
Giving a board seat, Paul should recuse himself. Paul should recuse himself from any vote at this point because he's now been proven to be pre-biased, okay, in wanting to swap the seat for a reversal of agreements. So whether or not he's asking for an apology or not, it is immaterial at this point.
Sure.
What you guys need to decide is, are you going to fill the seat with this